Rautio, you talked about that Google values being a trusted brand. I will tell you, I think that trust has been severely eroded. Google, as I understand it, was founded on a motto of don't be evil. There are more than a few Americans who have skepticism that Google is living up to that promise. You answered Senator Hawley that, well, gosh, the Economist and others have done studies. Did the Economist have access to Google's internal records?
No, Senator, I believe it was done externally. They ran a series of tests based on results that they were plugging into our search
engine. So one of the very frustrating things about this topic is there are very limited data. Much of this topic gets argued by anecdote, which is a less than satisfying way to consider any topic or to consider any analysis. And it yields things such as Democratic senators saying there is no censorship. The problem is Google has all the data, as does Facebook, as does Twitter. Let's see if we can get a little bit of that data. In the year 2018, how many ads by Republican office holders did Google block?
How many political ads?
How many ads by a Republican office holder to Google block?
I don't have the number off the top of my head. I would say the vast majority of ads that get submitted get run.
Will you commit to answering that question?
We'd be happy to come back to you.
And I want the same answer. How many ads by Democrats did Google block? How many videos by Republican office holders did YouTube block? How many videos by Democratic office holders did YouTube block? Those are objective.
Yeah, on the latter question, we looked into that. There were no videos blocked by Republicans or Democrat members of the Congress.
Okay, so my understanding actually is one of the members of this committee, Senator Marsha Blackburn, had one of her ads blocked because you deemed it shocking content.
What is that? Ads, again, distinguish ads from videos. I thought you divided those two. Ads, we have had both Democrats and Republicans on occasion be blocked. In the case of Senator Blackburn, yes, there was an ad that she submitted. It involved one of the people on the ad voicing an obscenity that...
Although that was bleeped out, is that correct?
That violates our policies. Well, it was clear what it was, apparently, and that was violated. So we went back, we talked to the senator.
Let me say, I appreciate your commitment to answer these questions, and I'm going to ask them to you in writing. Mm-hmm. If Google will answer some straightforward questions that provide the data, that may go a long way either to exonerating Google or to demonstrating there's a real problem. And not only on the metric of Republicans versus Democrats, also on the metric of how many pro-life ads has Google refused to run. This committee has heard testimony, for example, that the movie Unplanned, the true story about a former employee of Planned Parenthood, Google refused to run their ads. So that's a question I'd like an answer to. How many pro-life ads did Google refuse to run? How many pro-choice ads did Google refuse to run? Likewise, how many pro-Israel ads has Google refused to run? How many anti-Israel ads? Those data, right now, Google is a black box and nobody knows. Let me ask another question. What was the average ad rate Google charged the Trump campaign, the rate you charged across the board? And I'm going to ask you in writing, what was the average ad rate that the Trump campaign paid and the Clinton campaign paid? And if those two numbers are roughly equal, that will indicate one thing. If those two numbers are wildly different, that may indicate something else. And right now, it is Google that knows that, and as far as I know, nobody else.
If I may, again, just on ads specifically, all ads are not the same. In other words, if you are running a banner headline on YouTube, that may be a higher price than a lower, less.
That would be fabulous, and you're more than welcome to break it down. The average banner ad rate for the Trump campaign was X, and the average, if there are three different types of ads, break it down in whatever category, but compare apples to apples.
And if I could also, Senator, we do have all of the advertising spending for all members on our website where we publicize this. There's a transparency report that we put out annually on spending by candidates. It's all up there. Welcome to we'll be happy to point it out to your staff.
Now, let me ask you, some have asked, well, gosh, who would possibly think that Google was discriminating against conservative views? The senior leadership at Google, does it lean left or does it lean right?
Senator, senior leadership, that the whole team consists of people from a variety of different perspectives from outside of the United States, from American.
Mr. Bhatia, you're doing something rather remarkable, which is you're managing to be less candid than Mark Zuckerberg. Mr. Zuckerberg, when he testified before this committee, admitted Silicon Valley is overwhelmingly liberal, and anyone operating in the realm of simple reality would acknowledge that. Would you agree with that?
Senator, I go back to 100,000 people, 70, 80 different countries, leadership teams pulled from all over the world. I don't think it's a matter of easy caricature. The days when we were just a Silicon Valley company.
Let's focus on some simple data. It's where data is helpful. I did an FEC analysis in 2016 of senior executives at Google, people who had the title of some form of executive, vice president, or director. Found at least 88 unique senior officials at Google who made contributions to the Hillary Clinton campaign. 88. Do you know how many senior executives at Google made contributions to the Trump campaign?
Senator, it's not my business to look into that.
Care to field a guess? Zero. Goose egg. Not a single one. This ain't close that you can't say, gosh, I don't know anything about the politics here.
That is disconnected from reality. Let's look at another example. Senator Blackburn asked about the advisory council that you put together on artificial intelligence. One of the people on that advisory council was Kay Coles James,
mm-hmm.
who was the head of the Heritage Foundation.
Yes, sir.
You worked at the Heritage Foundation.
I did.
I believe you said. Do you consider the Heritage Foundation some fringe organization?
No, Senator, I consider it a conservative organization.
So 2,500 Google employees signed a petition to have Ms. James removed from the council. And they said, quote, by appointing James to the ATEAC, Google elevates and endorses her views, implying that hers is a valid perspective worthy of inclusion in its decision making. This is unacceptable. So you have 2,500 employees at Google saying that Ms. James, who, by the way, is an African-American woman, was one of the first women to desegregate the Richmond public schools. 2,500 Google employees saying that her view is not valid or worthy of inclusion. Google, in response to this, dissolved the entire committee. Do you understand when you see that kind of bias saying a conservative African-American woman's views are not valid and not worthy of inclusion, that the American people would say, these guys are silencing voices they disagree with?
Senator, the 2,300 amounts to something around 2% of the Google employees.
But Google acted on their recommendation.
No, Senator.
It dissolved the committee.
We did not, Senator. What happened in that situation was it was a committee that consisted of a number of members. Time progressed, a number of members of the committee, other than Ms. James, decided to fall off the committee, to withdraw from the committee.
So is it your testimony, Mr. Bhatia, because I'm finding this difficult to credit. Is it your testimony that Google did not dissolve the committee because your employees were mad that anyone right of center was included?
We dissolved the committee, Senator. I think we were clear at the end of the day that it was not going to be viable to continue the council, given what we were seeing happening with other members of the committee.
In a March 18 email to at least 17 other Google employees, Google employee Liam Hopkins stated that, quote, PragerU, Jordan Peterson, Ben Shapiro et al. Are all Nazis. This is a quote. Are using dog whistles. He further suggested that Google isolate this, quote, far-right content. Is it your judgment that Mr. Prager, Mr. Peterson, and Mr. Shapiro are Nazis?
No, Senator.
At least two of the three, Mr. Prager and Mr. Shapiro, are Orthodox Jews. Are you familiar with any Orthodox Jews who are Nazis?
No, Senator.
Is that not a horrifically offensive, nutty statement?
Senator, we have 100,000 people in the company, and there are 5-7 times the number of people work in Congress. We have people who will say things on chat rooms and other things.
There were 17 Google employees on that email. Did even one of them object to this characterization?
I don't know whether they did or not, Senator. We have a lot of these chat rooms that go on. People say things in chat rooms that certainly don't reflect the views of the company. It's not unlike many other workplaces around the world where people may say things that, don't reflect the views of the leadership team or management, where, you know, it is what it is.
Do you understand why people would be skeptical of Google's judgment and the radical politics of Google's employees when you believe Orthodox Jews like Mr. Prager and Mr. Shapiro are secretly Nazis?
Again, Senator, this is a statement that was made by an individual employee on some chat room board.
Google executive Jen Janai was videoed saying that Google is, quote, training its algorithms with an eye to prevent something like 2016 from happening again. Is that what Google is working to do? And here's the quote. We're also training our algorithms, like if 2016 happened again, would the outcome be different?
So, Senator, this was taken, I believe, from the Project Veritas videos where Ms. Janai was, who is a Google employee without responsibility for our search algorithms, was secretly videotaped without her consent. Her reference that you're quoting here and that the video subsequently made was to activities that we have undertaken to make sure that election interference that was seen, foreign state interference in the elections that was seen in 2016, does not happen again. That's what the reference is to.
Well, I think one of the best things to come out of this hearing is your commitment to answer the clear and direct questions from this committee with real numbers and specific hard data on Google's practices. That will go a long way to providing transparency that has far too long been missing. And let me echo both Senator Blumenthal and Senator Hawley that I would strongly advise Google submit to an independent third-party audit that has no bias, that has no axe to grind, with access to Google's records. An audit that doesn't have access to the record is meaningless. Your competitors are doing so, and I believe the American people expect transparency from all of big tech. Senator.